In this illustration, we'll discuss about a stress and two rods joined end to end. We are given the two rods of seam length of brass and steel of equal cross-sectional area joined end to end as shown in figure and supported between two rigid walls. And we are given that initially the rods are unstrained, and if the temperature of system is raised by delta T, we are required to find the displacement of the junction of rods. We are given that the coefficient of linear expansions and Young modulus of these rods as alpha V alpha S Y V and Y S. And we are also need to consider alpha of brass is more than alpha of steel. So, in this solution we can write if initial length is L0, on raising the temperature by delta T, free expansion in rods will be, here I am considering free expansion means if the rods are independent, then we can write delta L of brass, we can write as L naught alpha of brass times delta T, and delta L in steel will be L naught alpha of steel into delta T. Here, if the rods are independent, both will expand in this way, and as alpha B is greater than alpha S, brass will expand more. But here in the given situation, as the rods are rigidly attached to the two walls of which the separation remains constant, then obviously as brass will expand more, the junction will be displaced. Here we can redraw the figure to understand it better. These are the two walls between which the rods are placed. Here we can say if we talk about brass, and if it is independent, this brass will expand toward right by a distance delta LB. And if a steel were alone, this will expand toward left by a distance delta LS. But here in this situation, this would be the final position of junction, or we can say that junction will be displaced by a distance X. This we can write as final position of junction after heating. Now in this situation, if junction is displaced toward right by X, we can see brass will get compressed elastically by length delta LB minus X, and steel will get compressed by length delta LS plus X. So, in this situation, we can calculate after heating the system strain in brass rod, we can calculate this equals to delta LB minus X divided by L0. Initial length we can consider as L0, as this delta LB is very small compared to brass length L0. And similarly, we can calculate the strain in a steel rod as this given as delta LS plus X, as the steel rod will get compressed by the whole length delta LS plus X divided by L0. And here as the normal reaction on the two walls will be equal as the system is at rest, at everywhere in the volume of brass and steel, stress will also remain same. So here we can write as system is at rest. This implies we can use the stress in brass should be equals to the stress in a steel rod. Now, this stress we can write as, here we can continue. Stress we can write as Young modulus of brass multiplied by strain in brass should be equals to Young modulus of steel multiplied by strain in steel. So, if we substitute the values, This will give us Young modulus of brass multiplied by delta LB minus X divided by L naught is equal to Young modulus of steel multiplied by delta LS plus X divided by L naught. Here you can substitute the value of delta LB and delta LS, and after simplifying here, this will give us the value of X, which you can verify. That will be YB alpha B minus YS alpha S multiplied by L naught delta T divided by YB plus YS. You can solve this and verify the result, which is the final result of this problem.